everyone. Yesterday we have discussed about the introduction to economics. Yes, of course, what is economics? Who is the father of economics? Adam Smith is considered as a father of economics, and he has given this wealth definition. In his, he has mentioned acquisition of wealth is the main aim of the plan. Yes, and at last we have accepted the Alfred Marshall definition because he ignored the welfare of the human being, who Adam Smith. And Mr. Alfred Marshall, he criticized the Adam Smith definition, and he has given the new definition in his book, Principles of Economics, and he gave a definition about the economics. Economics is the study of mankind in ordinary business of life. Yes, we have discussed what are the who is the ordinary man and the ordinary business of life. Man can be a producer, seller, consumer, service provider, service holder, many things we have discussed in last class. And one more thing, the ordinary business of life, what are the activities will be happening in the economic activities, which consist of monetary gain, I said, production, consumption, distribution, exchange, so many things will come. So many things we have discussed in the last class. Now we are going to discuss about the third definition given by economist. His name is Lord Lionel Robbins. The definition is scarcity definition. Of course, first definition was given by Adam Smith. He is considered as a father of economics. And Alfred Marshall, he gave the welfare definition. He is considered as a father of microeconomics. And at last, those new people, they consider only wealth and welfare. But he is a present economist, neoclassical economist. He considers not only the wealth and welfare should be concerned, and scarcity also should be concerned, because we are the human beings, we have unlimited wants, but the resources are limited. So he has given his own point of view, new definition, which is scarcity definition, which was given by Professor L.L. Robbins, which means Lord Lionel Robbins. Okay, his book name is An Essay into the Nature and Significance of Economic Science, his book name. And in his book, he has given the scarcity definition, which is economics is a science which studies the human behavior as a relationship between ends and scarce means which have alternative uses. What do you mean ends and scarce means? He is saying economics is a study of science. It's not at all an arts or political science or economics is a separate. It's a study of science. You will be knowing what is this science. Okay. So economics is a study of science. Science is a kind of research thing. Whatever it is, it should be proved. Okay. Without proof, it won't be accepted in science, isn't it? Okay. So economics is a study of science, which is studying the human behavior as a relationship between ends and scarce means, which have alternative uses. Okay, here we use the different terms ends, scarce means, and alternative uses. Already I told you scarcity definition. First, you should know the meaning of scarcity. Scarcity, which means shortage or limited resources. I have a scarce of water. I have a scarce of resources. I have a scarce of money. Scarce of money. So, scarce, which means limited or shortage. Okay. He used the three different keywords or different words, which are ends, scarce means, and alternative users. Okay. Alternative users. Here, we are going to discuss about the ends. What do you mean by ends? In economics, his point of view, ends, which mean human wants. Okay, our wishes. Human wants, which mean yesterday I was saying the human wants can be classified into basic necessities, like comfortables and luxurious items. Okay, whoever it is, whether it can be a rich people, middle income group or low income group, being a human being, we need an essential first, food, shelter, clothing. Okay, once we satisfy our basic necessity, our wants will be increasing. For example, if you see the small kid, what do you want? If you ask, no, some people will be there, no, don't want, they will say, they will hesitate to tell to other people. Okay, if you are relative or cousin or so much close relation or friends, they will ask chocolate or whatever. After getting satisfied to the parents, especially not to the friends, to the parents, first they will ask their cycle or whatever it is. After getting the cycle, what they will ask? Bike. And later, their wishes will keep on moving. It never ends. Human wants are unlimited, but the resources are limited. Why I am saying resources are limited? We will discuss. First, ends. What do you mean by ends? Ends, which mean human wants, our wishes, to satisfy our wants. Okay, I want to become a doctor, I want to become an engineer, I want to buy a long class, I want to wear so many costly jewels. I need a imported bikes. You people will be having a wishes, huh? I want to become a journalist, a chartered accountant. So many wishes. Okay, once you become a chartered accountant after completing your UG, PG, if somebody comes to you and asks, you will say, yes, my sir, all sir, satisfied, I finished my life, I completed, no, you never say, because that time the new bonds will be arised. Okay, so ends which mean human bonds. Next, means which mean, he said, no, scales means, already I told you meaning, scales which mean shortage or limited. Scales, S-C-A-R-C-E, scales which mean shortage or limited. Available very less, limited. So, see here, means which means resources like land, labor, water, fertilizer, etc., which are limited in availability. Okay, whatever we require. For example, I told you, my wishes, if being a student, you will be having a wishes to come to college, study, and have so many extra things that like gadget, electronic gadget, and mobiles and bikes, many things you will be having, but you will have a realist resources, which means you are dependent to your parents and parents are income earner. Their income may be 20,000 or 25,000 or 30,000. Within the 30,000 only they should prepare the family budget. Within the 30,000 they have to spend for their children's education, family provisions, rent, electricity bill, water bill, and the medical expenses, cloth or any festival comes there for that, milk, etc., etc. So the resources, which means in your family wise, if you see, it is the money. So the money is less, but if the children's wishes and the family member wishes and the head of the family wishes and the wife, the spouse wishes will be more and more. So here means resources like land, labor, water, fertilizer, food, etc., which are very less in available. Okay, so limited in available. Next, he used the word ends and scarce mean which have alternative uses. Okay, alternative uses mean the same resources can be used for multi-purpose. That's what he has explained. So he explained, economics is a study of science which is study the human behavior as a relationship between ends and scales mean which have alternative uses. Yes, I have a human wants. Human wants are unlimited, but the available resources are very limited. These limited resources also having the multiple purpose. For example, electricity also we can take as a shortage of resources. Yes, we need a power more because we use for household activity, industrial activity, agricultural activity, and A to Z. Without power, you can't use, isn't it? So, these are alternative uses. So, human wants are used. Definition by Werner Robbins is, economics is a study of science which is study the human behavior as a relationship between ends and scarce means which have alternative uses. Okay, so alternative ends which mean human bonds, scarce means which mean limited resources, means which mean resources, scarce means which mean limited or shortage of resources. So human bonds are unlimited, but our resources, availability of resources are limited, and there is a relationship between these two which have alternative resources. These available resources also having, for example, if your parents are giving 10 rupees or 5 50 rupees, 20 rupees packet money today to your college, then you come for regular classes. Within the 20 rupees in college, they are going to ask you for the exam fees. So, what will happen? With the same money, you can buy so many things. So money is the resource, and which have the alternative uses to purchase many things. That is why you want. I want to take a ticket or bus pass, and I want to pay for the college or some fees they are asking, and I want to buy the stationery or chocolate, and with my friends I am going to the canteen to have something, and so many wishes you will be having. So by that time, what may happen? The necessity makes the ignorance children, the father of prudence. The same way, when you have a limited resources, but your wishes are more. Being a student, I am saying you are the initial stage. You people only will decide which is primary, which is secondary, which is later. So you don't spend for the unnecessary first. With the 20 rupees, if you go to canteen, no, you can't get any stationery for college purpose, and you don't get the money for the ticket to reach the home back. Okay, you will decide that time, the common sense will use for the normal people. So that is the thing, the wants are unlimited, resources are limited. For example, money, packet money, I said. You have a 20 rupees, suppose you will list out the wants. The same way family members, the head of the family will decide the prepare the budget. Okay. Okay, so if you decide later in the essential, think of it after the, by reading the essential necessities. If you go for the unnecessary things, buying some other snacks or some other things, you will miss the essential part. That's why the alternative uses of resources give rise to problem of choice. Okay, you have a 20 rupees packet money. Within the 20 rupees, you have to choose which is primary, which is secondary, which is later. Problem of choice. Okay, they raise the problem of choice with me. You have to choose among the list of primary, secondary, tertiary, later. And next, the examples for shortages in daily life. See, long queues in railway station, cinema theater, ration shop, you would have seen in the library, wherever you go, there is queue system right now, isn't it? Wherever, even freebies, wherever they are giving, wherever you go, there is a queue. Why they are giving queue? The wants are unlimited, but the available resources are limited. Okay, college, they are saying only 40 seats are available, first comes first. So that is, the seats are reserved, the limited, but the children are more to join in the particular college, so they will come first. They will stand in a queue. So long queues in railway station, the people wants to book the ticket for the particular train, but the queues are more. So first come, first to get the ticket. So these are the other examples of shortage. The wants are unlimited. That's why wherever you go, you will get a, okay, the alternative choice also is there. Suppose if you don't get a railway ticket and you will go for the bus travel. And so many choices are there to transport from one area to another area, though the resources are limited. Your wants are unlimited. People are more to go for travel, but the transport mode of transport is less. Okay. Then next one, how will you choose wants to be satisfied? How will you choose wants to be satisfied? This is the discussion concept, huh? You will be having a question answer also. Okay, how will you choose? Just now I gave you an example about the alternative choose the alternative users and means, scarce means. Okay, scarce means. Scarce means, okay, alternative uses. Scarce means means shortage of resources. Human wants are unlimited, but the resources are limited. Within the limited resources, they have to choose which is primary want, secondary want, later things. So, for example, if your parents are given the packet money, within the packet money, you should decide. The same way, if you are the head of the family, the your father or mother, they have to select which is primary for this month. Within the limited income, they have to spend for the, this year, the academic, the child is getting completed 10th standard and PUC should be admitted, mean they will spend most of the amount to pay for the admission, isn't it? They don't spend for the festival for this August or September month is coming. They have to spend more for the festivals, and education can be done by next year. Will they do? No, they will not do. They will do the list of, okay? List of. They will make a list. So the alternative resource of resources will raise to the problem of choice. Will give the rise to the problem of choice. Okay, alternative resources. The money is having alternative, money has alternative uses. But the parents or head of family, they should choose which is primary or secondary for the every month. Okay, next month, next month. Next. So by choosing the primary, secondary, tertiary wants, the wants should be choose. Sorry? The choose wants to be satisfied. The human wants to be satisfied on the basis of preferences, which is primary, secondary, later. Essential should be satisfied first. Later on, comfortable and luxurious item. Yesterday what I said, the human wants can be classified into essential, comfortable and luxurious. Next, the scarcity is the root of all economic problem. Here, scarcity is the root of economic problem. He is saying on, who said scarcity? Lionel Robbins, L. Robbins. He said the scarcity is the root of all economic problems. You know the meaning of root. Yes, all economic problems, what to produce, how to produce, for whom to produce. Every question will arise. The same way with consumer, what to consume, how to consume. So what can be purchased within my income and the market prices, and which is my essential right now. So everything. So scarcity is the root of, that's what he is saying. The resources, not human wants are unlimited, but the resources are limited. The available resources having the alternative uses. So the alternative uses of resources give rise to problem of choice. See here, the scarcity is the root of all economic problems. For example, the long queues in railway station, cinema theater, ration shop are all manifestation of scarcity of resources in our daily life. So this is the thing. Next one, here wants are unlimited, resources are unlimited, those resources having the alternative use. So these things are examples of scarcity of resources, and they have to choose the decision. Here, we are not living in this country with plenty of all resources. Wherever you go, it can be in USA or wherever it is, the resources are limited, but human ones are unlimited. We are in a world with a scarce of resources because of human activity only. So we should choose which is preference, which is primary and secondary. And now we will go for the discussion forum. Okay? We will discuss some of the few questions. What I have explained the concept from this only, these questions are there. Number one, scarcity is the root of, just now we discussed, all economic problems. Yes, because of shortage only, the problems are arising. The producer will think, okay, what I am going to produce because I have a 50 lakh or 5 lakh of investment. So within the investment, whether I can start a small scale industry or medium scale industry or large scale industry, which kind of product I am going to produce, consumer goods or private goods or intermediate goods, and for whom I am going to produce, for government or firm. So many discussions should be done. So scarcity is the root of all economic problems. This is the answer, huh? Scarcity is the root of all economic problems. Next, alternative uses of resources gives rise to problem of choice. Just now I said, the resources are limited, but it has the alternative uses. So they have to choose which is primary, secondary, later. They have to choose on the basis of preferences, giving preferences. And long queues at railway station, cinema theater are all manifestation of scarcity. Which means shortage of resources, scarcity of resources. And next one, resources are limited, but human wants are unlimited. Already we have discussed about this. Resources are limited and human wants are unlimited. Primary human wants are unlimited. And last two questions we are going to discuss. Mention the two scarcities in your daily life. Every day, what are the scarcities you are seeing in your daily life? You can say many things: electricity, food, water, and land, etc. So these things are shortage in all the time. And next one, this is another two more question mark. And write any two resources which have alternative uses. Of course, electricity, water, you can say. Yes, electricity can be used for multi-purpose, household activity, agriculture, and many things, etc. and so on. And water, of course, drinking water. Without water, you can't do anything, isn't it? Construction of house or making into the house. And go through the most knowledge of whatever sir is sending for you, and go through the videos. Thank you very much. We'll discuss in next class. Thank you.